Hey, what's going on, y'all? Back at you with a video here. I'm actually just going through my recce ruck, my EDC pack slash get home bag, and I've been using it now, and it's weighed about 20 pounds. But I did take out some stuff to lighten the load down. Plus, I had a lot of stuff in here for survival or get home type situation that I really didn't need, but I kind of already had it in the bag, and I basically took my EDC and then my get home and put it together. But anyways, but it was just a little bit too much than I'd rather have for EDC. But it was good for the survival end, but which I still got plenty of survival gear in here, but the bare bones to get through in a situation like that. But I have everything I need. So anyways, I'm just doing a video real quick, putting everything back in the bag. I had one item that was going to be added in this, and it was actually related towards food, hydration, and more food supply. And I just got my bucket from Nutrient Survival. I ordered the Black Scout, the second bucket of the Black Scout Survival. And that was the new one that Jack got with Nutrient Survival. And they came up with the NREs. And instead of MREs, NRE. But basically had all the small package, single packages of their freeze-dried food, the ones that Jack likes. Also has some hydration, electrolyte packages in there. Had protein powder mix in there. Even had their vitamin coffee package in there. So it was a great on-the-go or a great MRE type setup, but with their food, and they call it the NRE. Anyways, I ordered the bucket that comes with the NREs plus the packages of the freeze-dried food, and I finally got it after waiting since August. I ordered it. They didn't ship them out to, I guess, the end of August because they were waiting for the sale to be over at the end of the month, and in September they started shipping them out, which I had gotten in touch with them at the end of August just to make sure that's what they told me, what was going on. They were waiting for all the pre-orders to come in, then they were gonna send everything out. And then I didn't get my package. I never was alerted or anything told to me, you know, as far as my package being in at my P.O. box. And then I sent another email asking, you know, where the package was and this and that. And then they said it was on the way, that it was shipped out and it would be there. Never heard anything, never. I went to the post office. They didn't have a key in there like they normally do for the bigger containers for your bigger packages. Nothing was ever in there. And then, which, you know, that could have been a lot on the post office end. And then I sent them another email asking where my package was. And then they showed me the form saying it was delivered and it's there. And if I didn't get it out by September 17th, they were going to be taking it out of the container at the P.O. box. So I'm like, okay, well, I didn't get the key for him. I don't know what's going on. Anyways, I finally got the package. The post office had it in the back and I got it. Well, anyways, I opened it up and it's the wrong container. It's actually, looks like the first one, or it's actually just their container. It's the first go around of the Black Scout Survival container, which is a great container. It has all the big packages of freeze-dried food and all the good ones in there. The lasagna ones in there, that's a good one. But anyways, it has all that in there, and but it did have the NREs in there. And then the bucket is actually the different one. They had a different logo for the new Black Scout. It actually had the Black Scout Survival Crest on the bucket. It's not even that. It's not even the symbol or the crest for the first go around on the buckets. It's actually theirs crest on it. And the bucket was damaged. The top, I got it over here in the box. I just sent them an email with my complaints. But the bucket, the top won't snap. It's broke. And then, but really what pissed me off, you know, I didn't get the NREs. I was kind of looking forward to having those to put into my EDC get home bag, my recce ruck for more food supply. But I didn't get that. But what really got me upset was the protein powder mix package had a freaking huge gash in it, probably from the, because the top's broke. The top's not even, won't snap. So somehow maybe in the delivery, the top must have busted one of the that bag open. It's got a cut in it about that long. And there was protein powder mix all in the damn bucket, all the packages everywhere. So I took pictures showing it, sent the pictures to them, sent them an email with a complaint. And, you know, I'd like to get a new protein powder mix packet and also the NREs that I didn't get. So it's kind of the only complaint I've had with Nutrient Survival and the only issue I've had, but, you know, it is what it is. So I'm hoping to hear back from them and get this situated and get it sorted out. And then when I do get the NREs, I'll probably go ahead and put those in here. Plus with the stove, I got the Black Scout Survival Camping Stove Kit with everything I need to boil water using alcohol. And I can put that in there with the NREs, plus the protein bars and snacks and stuff I showed before. But anyways, when I put the bag together during the hurricane, which everything, we were blessed for the during the hurricane, thank God. I really feel bad for a lot of other people though. You know, even though it shifted away from us, you know, I'm in Ocala in Central Florida here, and it shifted and went towards the east and hit Daytona and all them. So we were very blessed on where we're at. It's one of the benefits of being here in Central Florida, especially in the area I'm in, Marion County. And that's always the benefit being here because of the hurricanes. Anyways, we were sitting in here in the house, you know, I was bored, and I'd been meaning to switch my EDC bag over because my Sabroso was done and it was bit the dust and I couldn't use it anymore. So I did that while the storm was going, and I didn't really go into detail what was in the bag. Just kind of talking real quick about the update I did to my bag, but you know, as far as the new one I'm using. But anyways, I thought I'd just show it real quick what I'm putting in here and what I have in here. And like I said, the only thing that was going to go in there that I don't have is NRE. But just quick run through. Still got a full container of water, Black Scout Survival canteen, which, you know, I got the Nalgene bottle, Nalgene Black Scout bottle. I actually keep that in my truck in the cooler full of water all the time. And, you know, that's one thing Jack's been talking about here a lot, you know, with a lot of products and stuff that has a lot of estrogen in it, you know, with lowering men's testosterone and how that's a huge problem today with a lot of men. They have low testosterone levels, which I'm one. I'm 42 years old, and I did have low testosterone levels, which if you haven't checked it out, go check out the Turkestone. I think I did a video showing it. Jack's talked about it if you want to go check it out, but I've been using that now for three months now. I've been using it. Just ordered some more of it. I love it. I've seen a huge difference in my energy. I don't get the not really leg cramps, but you know, just kind of like aching and pain in my legs, which I do a lot of walking, so you know, that has a lot to do with it. But it got worse and worse where it wasn't normal, so kind of took the aches away as far as the legs went. And then you know, more energy. And then as far as fit wise, you know, I feel better. You know, I'm getting more slender, just lightweight and a lot of cardio. But this winter I'm going to be actually hitting the weights and working out and hitting the weights again. And I'm at 180 right now at 5'9", and I'm gonna try to get 200 muscle mass, and then get up 200 hitting the weights, plus taking the Turkestone, I think is how you pronounce it, supplement. So anyways, definitely check that out if you haven't seen that. But back to the Nalgene bottle. Jack quit selling the plastic containers because plastic has a lot of estrogen in it, and that's one of the reasons why he got away from that, and he did the metal canteens now. So you know, anywhere you can get away from plastic, you should. I'm trying. It's kind of hard for me, but you know, I'm trying to figure out, you know, doing what I do for a living. I drink a lot of water, and I always get the gallons, and then I fill up the Nalgene bottle and all that. But it's yeah, you gotta figure it out. I mean, it's pretty bad on how bad estrogen is in so many products, and testosterone levels are so bad in men. But there's a lot of things food wise, you know, foods you can eat and this and that that can help build your testosterone levels. So but I love that supplement, and I think I showed a picture on the tribe, you know, as far as, you know, how I feel and how I'm looking and getting better and feeling better. So anyways, very important, physical health number one, especially when it comes to preparedness and prepping You got to be in physical fitness or you won't survive. You won't make it. So anyways, canteen on the outside. I still got the bunker here with cash in it for emergencies. And then I also went ahead to make room in the bag. I went and threw my, this is the Black Scout Survival water bag here, which, you know, probably another issue as far as estrogen. I'm not for sure as far as the material, if that would be a problem, but probably is, because everything's so freaking bad now, but as far as that situation goes. But I did put this on the outside because this I would have this full water and I would have it on the outside if I was walking a long distance and I need to get some water real quick. I could just drink out of that and not have to stop moving. So this would be out here. The only thing I don't have out here right now that will be on here on this side would be a whistle. I would be putting my emergency whistle, which is actually in my Black Scout Survival Signal Kit, Survival Kit. That whistle would be going on here and be clipped on the outside for, you know, so I can get, for emergencies, you know, and to get in touch with somebody or let somebody know if I needed them or something. So anyways, and then you got the, like I said before, I got the Black Scout reflector. The only reason I have this on here is for the reflector part. So if I'm at night, I'm walking, cars are coming behind me, the light hits this, it reflects back and they can see me. So that was why Jack came out with that. I got it up high so you can see it. Now I did get rid of the tarp because I didn't need that tarp. I actually need it for backpacking for scouts. So I did take the tarp out. I don't really have a shelter set up. I do have some heavy metal trash bags and paracord and stuff for a quick, easy shelter to put up if I had to, but I don't have on plans on having a shelter in a get home situation. It's keep moving, keep going to get home. So anyways, and for EDC, I really didn't need that. But that's basically, that's all on the outside. And then I got my RZ mask here that goes here on the sleeve on the back. I got it clipped with the carabiner here at the top. RZ mask, I use this at work, especially during the winter time when things get dry, and springtime when the pollen gets real bad. If I need it, I got it. But also for emergencies and emergency situation, something like the Twin Towers, a lot of debris, a lot of dust and stuff. I definitely want to make sure I got a mask, and I always keep my sunglasses with me at all times. So when I'm at work and I'm gone, so I always have a pair of sunglasses. But anyway, so but I'm just putting stuff back in the bag. This bag has two compartments here, up here in the front, and then just a main compartment in the middle, and then a back sleeve compartment here. But I think I'll do this two small ones. Got my allergy medicine, Flonase. I do have allergies and do them on and landscaping. It makes it even worse. I got my backup mag. Got some keys for the post office, stuff like that. I got my pen here from Black Scout. That was the tactical pen, one of the best ones on the market. Can't get that, I don't believe anymore. And then I got my pepper spray here, put out by Palm pepper spray. The only downfall to this is if you got large hands. I got medium hands, so for me it's not bad. I can, you flip the top up and get your thumb in and push down, and then it, you know, and it sprays. But if you got large hands, you know, a lot of guys with larger hands have problems getting their thumb in there and be able to use this pepper spray. So, but it is good stuff, good company. Go check them out. They might have bigger sizes now, different type setups. Here in the Recce Ruck, you got your little pin sleeves there, so I keep the pepper spray there, and then I keep the tactical pin right next to it. And the reason I keep it there is so I can get to a pin real quick. But also, if somebody was trying to rob me or do something in a situation, and I'm trying to go in my bag to distract them, you know, they wanted my wallet or whatever, and I say it's in my bag, and I can't get to any other weapons, I can pull this and get this in my hand, maybe cuff it, hide it, whatever, or have them go in the bag, but be able to get it to it and use it in a self-defense situation, and also for emergencies too. So anyways, I keep that right there. Top compartment, I just got everything kind of laid out here. I got, you know, survival stuff over here, and then EDC over here. Mag goes up on the top compartment, keys. Allergy medicine goes up there. And then I got my, this is my Ghost Knife by Bone Tactical. One of the main reasons why I have this in here is for cutting cigars. If I don't have a cutter on me, I can use this to cut the tips off, and it makes a great cigar cutter, being that it's a ceramic type blade. This is the Ghost Knife by Bone Tactical. He does have a new version of this. Definitely go check it out if you're interested. But the great thing about this knife, the reason I keep it in my EDC, if I can't bring my folding knife or any type of my flashlight with my strike bezel, my pistol, you know, my bone breaker, stuff like this, this is something I can sneak in through metal detectors and areas because there is no metal at all, even in the sheath, no metal at all in this knife. So I can sneak this into an area where there's metal detectors and I'm not allowed to have any weapons. I could stuff this down in my briefs and my underwear or, you know, my pocket or something and get it in. And it also does have the neck knife feature. And the great thing about Bone Tactical is on the snaps here, he makes it to where somebody's trying to choke you with it, the clip will come off and, you know, they can't choke you out. So, but anyways, but I'll go on the top up here. That way I can get to. And then, all right, so we'll jump over to Survival. I got some bug spray. Always want to make sure you got that down here in water. I do have a water filter and a backup filter for this water straw. So I do have that for the Survival. I have to purify water, to drink water. And I do have my, like I said, my signaling kit by Black Scout, something Jack put together. This was great for traveling. Didn't have any weapons in it. So you could bring this with you for traveling. I think the only thing I added in here was some of those glow-in-the-dark type lights in here. And I got a carabiner in there for that. I got it to where I could put this light here on the outside of my bag also for a reflector to tell people, you know, where show people where I'm at. But basically it has all the Survival gear you need and also signaling. You definitely wanna make sure you always have some type of signaling kit in a Survival situation so you can be rescued. So anyways, that's what's in that kit right here. And all that stuff, the Survival stuff goes down here in this bottom mesh compartment. And I do have another Survival kit in here, just back up to that one to have more supplies and more Survival supplies. And this is the combat kit that Jack put out by Black Scout. It used to be the best one he had. Now he's got a better one, but this is a great one that he made for the military, for the guys in combat. You know, you keep in your chest rig, and if you lay down on the ground, you're not smashing it up like the Survival or the tins that you know a lot of people have, the Altoid tins. That's why they put it in this container, so it's hard and take some damage impact. I did take the reflector that comes in here, and I can also use this as a reflector. It came in the kit, and Jack, you know, show you put it on the outside. And that way, if you got this in your cargo pocket or in your pocket, you can get to it. And then at night, if you need to get somebody's attention, or like in the military, you know, the guys in combat, they need to get in touch with each other. You can shine the light, you know, see where everybody's at, you know, and signal back and forth. So anyway, it's kind of a good little tip and trick there. And that's why I have this, which this would probably be on my person in a get home situation. I would have this in my cargo pocket and have this close to me just in case if I lost my bag, I still got some type of Survival kit on my person at all times, you know, for the Survival emergency Survival situation. So anyways, that goes down here with the other one. Go ahead and slide that in there. And then I also have my, this is the Running Boss kit, Pocket Runner's Aid kit. Just has a lot of essential items you will want to have. And especially in a get home situation, but for, you know, if you're going out on a run, if you're a runner, you do long distance running, this has everything you need in a small kit like that. Has, you know, chafing gel, Epic Whites. It's got blister bandages. It's got moleskin, sunscreen, electrolyte tablets, bandages, knuckle bandages, wing bandages, triple antibiotic ointment, petroleum jelly, used to start fires. And I got the electrolyte tablets in there too. So great kit to have on the go, and especially in a long distance travel, you know, in a get home type situation, great kit to have. So that's why I put that in here to add to the Survival compartment here of the situation. I got the water straw, backup filter, and then the bug spray will go same compartment. That way all the Survival stuff's in one area. And the backup filter I'll probably keep at the top here with my EDC stuff. That way it doesn't get lost. But anyways, Yeah, all the survival stuff in there. Oh, no, that's trash. All right, so there's that. And then here's my heavy metal trash bags. I do have a survival bivy by Black Scout. Jack still has these. If you definitely want to pick one, he's got them in orange and the green. I got the green in here for get home because, you know, I'm trying to stay low key and low visibility. Don't want anybody to see me if I'm in building shelter to sleep in the woods for the night in a bad situation, SHTF, whatever. I do have a survival bivy in there, but also blends in with my environment. I do have my mosquito net as a must for that situation if I'm gonna be using this as a shelter. And then I have my two heavy metal trash bags in here. Is it one heavy metal? I think it's one heavy metal trash bag I have in here. And that's also for the shelter kit. Stuff full of leaves for, you know, during the winter to stay warm. Plus with the survival bivy. Or I could stuff the leaves in the heavy metal trash bag, slide that, flip the survival bivy inside out, slide the heavy metal trash bag into the survival bivy and have the inside facing out to keep me warm, to reflect my body heat off the ground. That's what I do for a hammock during the winter time, and that works great to stay warm and not have a cold back and low body temperature. And I do have some wool socks in here too that I have. Always make sure I got an extra pair of socks in here. The only thing I don't have in here that goes with the whole survival kit, which I gotta grab, is my military poncho. I actually gotta go get that out of my backpacking bag because we're gonna use it for camping for scouts. And then I do have paracord here, you know, that goes with the shelter, plus the military poncho, which I can use as a tarp, you know, and set up that way for a roof. So anyways, so that's the only thing I gotta grab, that I just remembered. But I'll put that stuff here on the back side down here in the sleeve. Same thing with paracord, keep all that together. Actually, I'm probably put that in here last time. I got my navigation kit. This is a map of my area, and it has a compass, ranger beads, all that stuff, so I can keep track of my strides and walking. And I do have the Blast Scout Survival notebook pad, which has a Ride in the Rain paper in it, so I don't have to worry about that getting wet. And I also have a Sharpie and a pencil in here that came with the navigation kit. And I got some navigation information in here, you know, to teach me, you know, just some tips and tricks as far as navigating goes, and then reading a map and all that stuff in an area of mine. So navigation kit, definitely must have important item, especially in a long distance travel out of state. You definitely want to have some type of map up of your area. So, and then I got the paracord. The other thing is, I've always done this. I learned this a long time ago from, I think it was grandma prepper or something like that, but she always kept pictures of her family. And the reason for that is not just for morale, you know, a lot of guys in the military do that, you know, to see pictures of the family, you know, remind them, you know, why they're doing what they're doing, but also for you know, if you're looking for your family in a disaster or some type of SHTF type situation, you can't find your family, you need to have pictures so you can show people who, what they look like, and have, if they've seen them. So this is to help me find them in case of a situation, and I have pictures of everybody in there and try to keep up to date recent ones. So, but anyways, pictures, family, and then I'll put the paracord on top there, and that's pretty good there. Now everything else is basically going in the center compartment of the bag. And I got my power bank. I got my tool kit. This has got another notepad with a pen for backup, right in the rain. And I just got different multi-tools in here. I do have my torch in here for cigars. So I have a cutter and a torch for my cigar smoking in case I don't have one. And I got multi-tools, different multi-tools in here, universal wrench type system tool in here. And then I even have my knife sharpener in here. Touch up my folding knife, which I always keep. My That's one of the reasons why I don't have a full tang knife in here, because I do have my field knife. This is one that Jack puts out, thinks he still sells these, but one of the best folder knives you can get. And it's such a heavy duty type folder knife, you can use it out in the field for, you know, survival type situations and survival work. I got two multi-tools in here. I got my Leatherman and I got a small Leatherman squirt, and then other multi-tools. So basically just tool type kit is what I have here. I've always had that at my EDC. I already did the food. I got some MRE energy bars and stuff, the caffeine gum, and my Fit Crunch protein bars, best ones, best tasting and best ones are these Fit Crunch. If you haven't seen them, I get them at Sam's. They got two different ones. Amazing, good. And then trauma kit, it's my IFAT kit. It's got a couple tourniquets in there, chest seals, all the goodies in here for a great trauma kit. That's put out by 3V Gear, the bag here. And I even got the red indicator here to see at night, so I can pull the zipper, which that's actually from the Recce Ruck. Got that extra when I got the bag. Got my shooting gloves, tactical gloves, put out by Voodoo. Awesome gloves. I love those, and I use them at work too. And then dude wipes. I always keep TP in the trucks. I got plenty of toilet paper in there, but I also keep wipes on me just in case. And then the boo-boo kit. So that's all the everything that's in my EDC bag, but also for a get-home type situation. The only thing I got to put in here right now is my military poncho. And then, like I said, I was going to do the NREs. You know, for the food supply to add more food, which I would add in my camping stove that I have to boil water. But anyways, those are the only things I'm missing as far as that goes. But you know, if I get it, I'll put it in there. But just a quick run through. I didn't want to make it too long, which has gone long enough, and just kind of show you a great type setup on a great EDC plus get home type bag. And if you don't have one, everybody should have one in their vehicle at all times, no matter what, especially now with the way things are going in this world. It's just things are getting worse and worse, and it's only a matter of time when things are going to pop off and chaos is coming. So, and by the way things are looking, and if you haven't checked out the Tribe and Black Scout, go check them out. Black Scout Survival. Get with the Tribe, become a member, and it's a network of people all on the same page with the, you know, same mindset. And it's just a great way to meet new people in your area and your state, and all of us come together. And if something bad does happen, then we can all come together as a family and watch out for one another. So if you haven't seen that, go check that out. Go check out the Tribe, check out Black Scout. And also I've been watching Gun Girl Prepper's her YouTube channel. Great channel. She has a lot of great information. I like watching her because she keeps track of the stocks and the market and the economy and what's going on. Go check her out. Awesome channel. I think she's also with the Tribe and, you know, with Black Scout. That's where I saw her and that's how I found her. And awesome channel. So definitely go check her out. And if you're into the stocks, keeping track of all that, she's definitely somebody you want to watch to keep track of that information. So anyways, guys, I think that's it. Hope everybody's good. I hope everybody's blessed. Be safe out there. Like Jack always says in his videos, you know, stay strapped. Stay strapped, stay frosty, stay dangerous. You know, he don't say it just as a punchline. He says it because he means it, because we are living in a crazy world right now. Crime is through the roof. Evil is everywhere. The wickedness is all over the place on the streets. And it's time for God's people and the righteous to protect yourself and be ready for the fight when it does come, and just be prepared. So, but get ready. November's coming. We're going to see what direction we go in this country and keep praying for the best, but preparing for the worst. All right, y'all. Take care and God bless. See you on the next one.